सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहनाभवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यङ्करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकन्नामरूपयोः अतिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धिर्दृक्यत्वनिर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परमहः तदेवाहन्नमत्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। So we're looking at the Akshepa of the Purvapakshi. First up, Akshepa we saw as to Praptasya Prapti, Nitya Praptasya Prapti, and also Nitya Nivruttasya Nivruttihi. How can you have Praptasya Prapti, which is Paramananda Rupa, which is your Prayojana of this Vichara Sagara, whereas Paramananda is one's own Sarupa. How can you have Nitya Praptasya Praptihi and Nitya Nivritta Dukkha, which is all never there in Atma, because Atma's Sarupa is Sukha. How can you have Nitya Nivruttasya Nivruttihi? That was explained as to it is figurative because there is a pratiti of dukkha, although one's Sarupa is Ananda Rupa. Like an example was given, like the something that you have lost which is with you, which you are not really lost but you think it is lost. That is the example given for Praptasya Prapti and Nivruttasya Nivritti, Nitya Nivruttasya Nivritti. The Rajju was never in Sarpa, but there was a Pratiti of Rajju. There is Rajju Pratiti Karya also, which is Bhaya Rupa. Thereby, there is a possibility of Nivritti of Sarpa, the way it is possible in Sarpa Nivritti by knowing the Rajju Sarupa. Similarly, by knowing one's own Sarupa, there can be Dukkha Nivritti, which was Nitya Nivritta anyway, just like Sarpa was never there in the Rajju. So much we have seen. Dvitiya Akshepa is there. Second Akshepa comes up. Purvapakshi says, Nanu, Savilasa Adhyana Nivruttihi Paramananda Vaptischa Granthasya Prayojanam Iti Uktam Na Sangachate Yato Yato Nivruttir Nama Nishesha Nasha Eva नाशस्तु प्रध्वंसाभावः एव अतः अनर्थनिवृत्तिरूपाभावस्य परमानन्दप्राप्तिरूपाभावस्य च एकत्र मुक्तिस्वरूपे सामानादिकरणं न घटेत भावाभावयोः अन्योन्यविरोधात्। सो व्हाट ही सेज एंड फर्दर विरुद्धयोः धर्मयोः एकत्र युगपत् समावेशायोगाच्च तस्मात् उक्त प्रयोजनं ग्रंथस्य न संभवति इति चेत्। सो आक्षेप इज यू हैव सेड दैट देयर इज निवृत्ति ऑफ दुख। सो सविलास अज्ञान निवृत्ति दुख निवृत्ति यू हैव सेड, परमानंद प्राप्ति यू हैव सेड, नाउ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट अज्ञान निवृत्ति। अज्ञान निवृत्ति इज मोक्ष, परमानंद अवाप्ति इज ऑल्सो मोक्त, परमानंद अवाप्ति इज प्राप्ति। So prapti is bhava rupa, nivritti is abhava rupa. Ajnana nivritti is moksha, paramananda prapti is moksha. That is your prayojana of this particular grantha. That is not appropriate. Why so? There is a logical flaw. Yataha nivritti nama nishesha nashayeva. What do you tag as nivritti? What is called as nivritti? Nishesha nashaha. When ajnana goes away completely, nasha of ajnana. Ajnana is bhava Being bhava ajnana nivritti has to be abhava rupa. Now your nivritti of ajnana is abhava. Nisheshanasha, nothing remains. Ajnana is completely gone. So it is abhava of ajnana now. Whereas paramananda aptischa bhava rupa. So nisheshanasha is what completely gone is nashastu pradvamsa bhava eva. So this is a little tricky because Tarkika language is a little difficult. Those who have not studied Tarka can set it aside. I'll explain it nonetheless. I'll try to keep it simple. Abhavas are categorized by Tarkikas as, when I say Tarkikas, Nyaya Vaisheshika both are included. Pradhvamsa Abhava is one. There are four types of Abhavas: Pragabhava, Pradhvamsa Abhava, Anyonya Abhava, and Atyanta Abhava. So Abhava are Padarthas. In Nyaya, Nyaya Vaisheshika in Tarka, Abhava is a Padartha and categorized into four types. Pragabhava is before the creation. Ghata is a good example. They say before Ghata Utpatti, the Abhava of Ghata is, there was no Ghata before Ghata came about. So Abhava of Ghata before the Ghata came about, prior non-existence of Ghata is called as Pragabhava. Similarly, when the Ghata is destroyed, that time the latter Abhava absence is called as Pradhvamsa Abhava. So Nisheshanasha Nivritti is Pradhvamsa Abhava. There are other two also, Atyanta Abhava, they do not agree is possible, complete non-existence. And there is Anyonya Abhava. There is abhava of ghata in pata and abhava of pata in ghata, that is anyonya abhava. Our focus here is pradhvamsa abhava. Pradhvamsa abhava is after the nasha of ghata, the abhava that is there is called as pradhvamsa abhava. It is padartha, kashchana padartha. Here your ajnana nasha has happened, so you replace ghata with ajnana now. So after ghatanasha, how you have pradhvamsa abhava? Similarly, after ajnananasha, you have ajnana pradhvamsa abhava. So pradhvamsa abhava eva nashah. Ataha anartha nivritti rupa abhavasya, anartha dukkha nivritti, samsara nivritti, ajnana nivritti, that kind of abhava. Abhavasya paramananda prapti rupa bhavasya cha, abhava rupa nivritti. Ajnana nivritti is abhava rupa. That's one phala. Another phala is paramananda prapti, second phala. It is moksha. You are not saying that moksha is in stages. You are saying moksha is what? It is dukkha nivritti, meaning abhava, and paramananda prapti, which is bhava. So abhava and bhava cannot be in samanadikaranya. But you have it. Cha ekatra mukti swarupe, moksha swarupe, samanadikaranam na ghatet. So his question is, abhava rupa and bhava rupa cannot be in samanadikaranam. You say there is absence also and there is presence also. Na ghatet. Bhava bhavayoho anyonya virodha. They are opposed to each other. You cannot say existent as well as non-existent. Viruddhayoho dharmayoho ekatra yugapat samaveshayogaccha. They cannot go together. You cannot. They are viruddha dharmas. Abhava has a viruddha dharma. Bhava, the dukkha nivritti. Abhava dharma is viruddha to bhava rupa ananda. They cannot stay together. They'll have a conflict. Tasmad ukta prayojanam granthasya na sambhavati iti chet. Therefore, your grantha has no prayojana. Therefore, it should not be begun at all. You should not even think about this grantha. You should not create such a grantha. Tat samadhi. Tasya samadhi uchyate akshepasya. Naisha dosha. That is not a problem. That's not an issue at all. Why? Savilasa avidya nivrutte he adhisthana brahma chaitanya matratvat na tato atirichyate sa. संग्रह वाक्य, सविलास अविद्या निवृत्ते है, अविद्या निवृत्ति अलोंग विथ, अविद्या निवृत्ति अलोंग विथ इट्स कार्य, सविलास ऑल द विक्षेपा दैट इज गोइंग ऑन विल गो अवे व्हेन अविद्या गोज अवे, अज्ञान गोज अवे, सो निवृत्ति ही इज व्हाट, निवृत्ति सा निवृत्ति ही ततः अधिष्ठानात् न तिरिच्यते, अधिष्ठान ब्रह्म चैतन्यम, अधिष्ठान इज ब्रह्म चैतन्य, कल्पिता इज ऑन दी अधिष्ठान ब्रह्म, दि एंटायर प्रपंच आरोपित विक्षेप विक्षेपित जगत, प्रपंच इज ऑन ऑन अधिष्ठान, दि मिराज वॉटर इज सीन इन दि डेजर्ट, ऑन दि डेजर्ट, सो डेजर्ट इज दि अधिष्ठान, सिमिलरली रज्जु सर्प is seen, sarpa is seen on rajju, it is called rajju sarpa because rajju itself is seen as sarpa, meaning sarpa is kalpita on rajju, which is the adhisthana. Here in this case the entire prapancha is projected, imagined on brahma, brahma which is chaitanya matra, so brahma chaitanya matratvam kasya avidya nivruttehe tatah na atirichyate, it is not different. When you say, we say Nivrutti, Nivrutti is not Abhava Rupa. Nivrutti is Bhava Rupa in Adhisthana. What is called as Nivrutti is Adhisthana. Sarpa Nivrutti Kim? Rajju Adhisthana Rupa Meva. Rajju is the Nivrutti of Sarpa. Rajju Rupa. Rajju is Bhava Rupa. How can you say Abhava Rupa? We don't have a concept of Abhava itself. You have this erroneous system built on completely shaky foundation whereby you categorize abhava as a padartha first. We don't object it because for us there is nothing like creation and destruction. Vedantins say that there is manifestation and unmanifestation. Thereby if we say abhava is padartha, we don't have a problem there. Why? Because adhisthana, we look at it as everything is brahma, merges into brahma, avyakta becomes vyakta. But you start categorizing abhava and then you say abhava is absence, we have a problem there because it is not absence, it is presence of the adhisthana. Thereby, yatha aropita sarpa nivrutti adhisthana rajju matram evam kalpita namarupatmaka sakala vastu nivruttirapi tad adhisthana chinmatram eva na tato atirichyate idi siddham. So just in the example, the Rajju is the Swarupa of the Sarpanivrutti. When you say Sarpanivrutti is Abhava Rupa, it is not Abhava Rupa, it is Rajju Rupa, meaning Bhava Rupa Rajju Rupa. Rajju Rupa, therefore Bhava Rupa, not Abhava Rupa, and Bhava Rupa Adhisthana and Paramananda Prapti, which is also Bhava Rupa, there is no conflict at all. Where is the Virodha? Samanadikaranam is there, all right, but it is between Bhava Rupa of Adhisthana and the Paramananda Prapti, Ananda, which is also Bhava Rupa. We don't have Virodha. Tatha Adhisthanat Nati Richyate. It is Siddham. Aropita Pratiyogika Pradhamsasya Pratiyogyadhisthane Bhasamanasya Adhisthana Matratvaniyamat. He gives a rule that we apply here. This is a rule for Vedantins. We say aropita pratiyogika. This is the tarkika definition we are using. Tarkika uses pratiyogi. So we explain in the language that he understands. Without pratiyogi, he does not understand because abhava is pratiyogi. Yasya abhava sa pratiyogi. So ghatasya abhava uchyate chet ghata pratiyogi hoti. So here ghata abhava and ghata have a pratiyogi relation. Thereby, we say pradhvamsa is a, now pradhvamsa, yasya abhava, here aropita prapanchasya abhava uchyate. Thereby, aropita prapanchaha is pratiyogi. So, aropitaha prapanchaha dukkharupa samsaraha pratiyogi yasya pratiyogi yasya pradhvamsasya saha pradhvamsaha आरोपित प्रतियोगिकः, आरोपित प्रतियोगिक प्रध्वंसः, तस्य आरोपित प्रतियोगिक प्रध्वंसस्य प्रतियोगी अधिष्ठाने प्रतियोगी अधिष्ठाने भासमानस्य हाउ डू यू नो दैट देयर इज प्रध्वंस अभाव वेदांतिन विल से अनुपलब्धि प्रमाण बट तार्किका विल से देयर इज अ प्रध्वंस अभाव आई नो देयर इज अ प्रध्वंस अभाव सो व्हाट इज दैट प्रध्वंस इट इज भासमान और अभासमान इफ इट इज न भासते चेत यू कैन नॉट इवन टॉक अबाउट इट यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट प्रध्वंस अभाव बिकॉज यू आर एबल टू कॉग्नाइज दिस अभाव प्रध्वंस अभाव देयर बाय दिस प्रध्वंस अभाव इज भासमान सो भासमानस्य प्रध्वंसस्य प्रतियोगी अधिष्ठाने भासमानस्य वेर इज इट वेर डू यू नो दिस प्रध्वंस इफ घटाभाव इज नोन घट प्रध्वंस अभाव इज नोन वेर इज इट नोन If it was there in on the floor, then ghatatale ghatasya pradhvamsaha. Pradhvamsabhava is ghatatala. So ghatatala is adhishthana. Ghatatale bhasamanasya ghatapradhvamsasya yatha tatha aropita pratiyogika pradhvamsasya bhasamanasya. Kutra bhasamanasya pratiyogyadhishthane brahmani brahmatmani adhishthana matratva niyamat. तस्य प्रध्वंसस्य अधिष्ठान मात्रत्वम् दैट इज द नियम ड्यू टू दैट नियम व्हाट ततो न अतिरिक्त इति सिद्धम् निवृत्तिरपि ततः ब्रह्मणः आत्मना ब्रह्मात्मना भावरूप ब्रह्मात्मनः न अतिरिक्ता इति सिद्धम् दिस इज द हेतु नियम इज द हेतु फॉर सिद्धि ऑफ निवृत्ति नॉट बीइंग डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दी अधिष्ठान देयर बाय भाव रूपा एंड दिस इज सेड इन वार्तिका भगवान वार्तिककार सुरेश्वराचार्य सेज तदुक्तम वार्तिके अधिष्ठान अवशेषो ही नाश कल्पित वस्तुना इति अधिष्ठान अवशेष ही नाशः व्हाट इज नाशः नाश इज नश अदर्शने धातु ऑल्सो इज नश अदर्शने इन दी अदर्शन मीनिंग इट इज नॉट सीन Not seen does not mean complete destruction. It is not absence. It is unmanifestation. It is unmanifestation into what form? It is in the form of adhishthana. Gita Acharya also says, Nabhavo vidyate sataha. Sataha abhavo na vidyate. If it was there, it will never go away. Pratiti is there. That pratiti has gone away. But adhishthana, the satta is there. Satta is never destroyed. It is there in the form of the adhishthana. So here, prapancha dukkha rupa nivritti has happened. But then that nivritti is in the, you say abhava, we say it is abhava, pradhvamsa abhava, you can tag it anything. You call it pradhvamsa abhava, but pradhvamsa abhava and bhava rupa do not have an issue, do not have a conflict in our situation where we say, अभावा इज नथिंग बट आरोपितस्य अभावा इज नथिंग बट दी अधिष्ठान रूप भाव सो अधिष्ठान अवशेष ही नाश कल्पित वस्तुना एंटायर प्रपंच इज कल्पित देयरफॉर इट्स नाश इज नथिंग बट मर्जिंग बैक इनटू फिगरेटिवली मर्जिंग बैक इनटू अधिष्ठान अयमेव भगवत्पादादीनाम आशय आकरादिषु स्फुटतरः अयमेव दिस वेरी आइडिया इवन भगवान सुरेश्वराचार्य हैज नॉट इन्वेंटेड समथिंग न्यू इट इज नॉट अ न्यू फिलोसॉफिकल थॉट इट इज दैट विच भगवान भाष्यकार हैज आल्सो सेड भगवत्पादादीनाम एवरीवन बिगिनिंग विद भगवत्पादाचार्य इवन अर्लियर भगवत्पादाचार्य इज आल्सो सेइंग द सेम थिंग विच हैज सेड बीन सेड इन द श्रुति एंड टॉट इन द संप्रदाय आकरादिषु दिस कैन बी टेकन एज द एंटायर सेट ऑफ वर्क्स रिटन बाय भगवान भाष्यकार एज वेल एज भगवत पादाचार्य वी कॉल हिम बिकॉज अदर देन भाष्य इज ऑल्सो रिटन अ लॉट ऑफ वर्क्स ऑल ऑफ दोज वेदांत वर्क्स विच हैव बीन क्रिएटेड बाय भगवान भाष्यकार दे आर कॉल्ड एज आकर विथ रिस्पेक्ट इट इज कॉल्ड दिस इज लाइक वेर इट्स अ सोर्स ऑफ लॉट ऑफ जेम्स दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड आकर आकर आदिश स्फुटतर वेरी क्लियरली Very clearly, this is the very idea which is mentioned in every work of Bhagavan Bhashyakara, every Vedanta work, that there is no nasha of abhava, Nasha, in the sense of abhava, complete absence, it is always unmanifestation into the adhishthana. Atayeva prakrute api. Therefore, in the, this context also, anartha nivruttihi brahmamatram iti uktad doshanavakashaha. So, brahmamatratvam, nivruttehe brahmamatratvam uchyate. What we say is, nivrutti is not abhava rupa, but it is brahmamatra rupa, bhava rupa. Therefore, there is no question of a dosha here. You cannot point out any flaw, logical or otherwise. Sarvanartha drishya kalpana adhishthanatvad brahmana. Why so? Because Brahma is the adhishthana for the entire prapancha which is kalpita, which is seen drishya. Drishya prapancha, which is anartha rupa because it keeps you in samsara, in bondage, samsaranam. Samsara keeps you in samsarana. Therefore, anartha rupa, drishya, is all kalpana. And entire kalpana has to have an adhishthana. You cannot imagine on nothing. Imagination has to have a basis. That basis, the foundation is Brahma for everything which is kalpita. Tachcha Brahma, siddha vastu swarupatvad bhava rupam. And we know what is this Brahma. It is siddha. Siddha vastu, that it is bhava rupa. Brahma is not shunya. Brahma is bhava rupa. In fact, it is the only existent thing. It is the only real bhava rupa padartha. There is nothing else other than Brahma. Tasmad anartha nivruttehe bhava rupatvadeva tasyaha asmin granthe prayojanatva kathanam yuktameva. Tasya kasya nivruttehe. Tasya nivruttehe asmin granthe prayojanatva kathanam yuktameva. Iti. It is very appropriate that the prayojana is mentioned in this shastra, as the shastra prayojana is what? Nivritti of anartha, anartha rupa samsara, which is anartha, and that is bhava rupa. That nivritti is bhava rupa because it is brahma rupa, it is adhishthana rupa. That is paramananda. There is a tippana here. Just quickly go through it. Tadyatha hiranyanidhim nihitam akshetrajnya upari upari sancharanto na vindeyuhu evam eva imaha sarvaha prajaha ahar ahar gacchantyaha etam brahmalokam na vindanti anrutenahi pratyudaha. This is a chandogya mantra quoted. We'll see the bhavartha. Ityadi shrutyuktaritya grihe antarnihito hiranyanikshepo vidyamano api yavad avidyam avidyamanavad avidyaya apraptavad bhavati. So this is for the nivrutti here. Nitya praptasya. Nitya prapta is mentioned. Not nivrutti. Nitya praptasya praptihi vedanta grantasya paramam prayojanam sutaram upapannam eva. This we saw in the last patha. There is a tippanna to this. That is, what is this nitya prapta? There an example is given. There are a lot of earlier houses, village kind of setup where gold, which is considered as the main wealth, they were hidden. To protect, they were hidden. And whether they were hidden inside the house or, you know, mostly they were dug. There is a pit dug and the in pots, gold were hidden. Gold coins or something like that. So through the Chandogya Mantra, Chandogya Mantra is explained through an example. Look at the example. Grihe antarnihito hiranyanikshepaha vidyamana api. Although it is there, the later generations do not know about it. That's why there are people who come about and they say, you know, I can see that there is gold hidden in your house. I can help you get it. If you know about these village setups, there are people who can, they have siddhis whereby they can find out if there is something hidden in your house. And they can help you find it. They take a cut out of it. So, hiranyanikshepa vidyamana api yavad avidyam avidyamanavat. Avidya means yavad avidyam. as long as you have not got it, it is as though it is not there. So avidyamanavat avidyaya apraptvat bhavati. If the he is the owner, rightful owner of that gold, but he does not know, and not knowing it is as good as not having it, although it is nitya prapta, because it is in his own property. It is in his own property boundary, and it is his own as well, rightfully his own, because his forefathers, his ancestors hid it. He is the rightful owner, he owns it, but he does not know it. Apraptavat bhavati anjanadyupayehi jnatashchet praptavat bhavati. So these siddhas would put an anjana on the eye, so that it works on some people. They put an anjana as some kind of a magical ointment, you can say. It's a mystical thing. It is a mystical thing. We don't understand how it works. Mantra Shakti. So with that, they put an anjana on the eyes, and then they can see, the person can see that this is where it is. They can actually see. And when they see it, then they dig it and get it. So anjanadye upayehi jnatashchet, once it is known where it is, praptavad bhavati. It was already prapta, praptasya prapti. Similarly, is this atma swarupa, ananda swarupa, praptasya prapti, avidyaya apraptavad, jnanena vidyaya praptavad bhavati. Iyam eva nitya praptasya prapti rityuchyate. This is exactly what is nitya praptasya prapti. Yathayam drushtanta evam eva, and this is an example given. One Shruti has been quoted. Similarly, there are so many Shrutis. Iyam eva nitya praptasya praptirityuchyate. Yathayam drushtanta evam eva ayam atma brahma prajnanam brahma sarvam khalvidam brahma atmai vedam sarvam brahmai vedam sarvam ityadi shrutibhi sarvasya brahmatva upadeshena paramananda swarupasya swasya brahmatvat nitya praptatva नित्य प्राप्तत्वे अपि अविद्यया अप्राप्तत्व भ्रमः. एंड सो मेनी श्रुति सेज से दैट ऑल दिस इज ब्रह्म. अयम आत्मा ब्रह्म. आई एम ब्रह्म. अयम वेरी क्लोज. हाउ क्लोज? नॉट इवन अ सिंगल कोशा इज देयर. प्रत्येक आत्मा इज ब्रह्म. प्रज्ञानम ब्रह्म. आई एम ब्रह्म. दिस कॉन्शियसनेस इज ब्रह्म. आई एम कॉन्शियसनेस. आई एम कॉन्शियस. I know that I am conscious, that my Swarupa is consciousness. That is Brahma. Sarvam khalvidam Brahma. Here this can be a Mahavakya or Avantar Vakya based on what we understand by Brahma. If we know Brahma is Atma, then it is Mahavakya. Otherwise it is Avantar Vakya, because Asti. Brahma Asti. Sarvam khalvidam Brahma Asti. Asti padena paroksha jnanam jayate. If Asmi is added here, by understanding Brahma is me, then by prajnanam brahma ityadi, then brahma is prajnana, I am prajnana, therefore brahma is me. So brahmatma asmi, sarvam khalvidam aham asmi, thereby it will become aparoksha. Atmai vedam sarvam, brahmai vedam sarvam, same case everywhere. Ityadi shruti bihi sarvasya brahmatva upadeshena, everything is brahma. I am not separate from sarvam. I am also sarva. I am at least a part of sarva. Then I am the whole. Only the Shruti can tell you the part is not a part of the whole, but part is the whole. Paramananda swarupasya swasya brahmatvat. Yes, Paramananda swarupa is one's own swarupa, which is Brahma. Thereby nitya praptatve api. Although it is ever attained, this Ananda Swarupa is although attained, avidyaya apraptatva brahmaha. Avidya and avidya karya take away this Ananda as though, and thereby Ananda pratiti is lost on us. There is dukkha pratiti, therefore apraptatva brahmaha. Akhanda paramananda chidrupa brahma eva aham iti shruti yuktyanubhavaihi jayamana swaswarupa sakshatkara eva nitya praptasya praptirti. Sakshatkara is nitya praptasya prapti. What is that sakshatkara? Shruti yukti anubhavaihi. So shruti yukti and anubhava is shravana manan nididhyasana, basically. Through that jayamana swaswarupa sakshatkara. Knowing one's own swarupa, immediately sakshatkara paroksha jnana. That itself is nitya praptasya praptihi. How? Akhanda paramananda chidrupa brahma eva aham iti. That Paramananda Chidrupa Brahma I am, which is akhanda, never segmented, and the highest sukarupa. Then there is the second tippana there. Looking at the number, somehow it's difficult to look at the number on the top. It's mean. So anyway, we look at the tippana. Rajvam pratiyamana sarpasya rajju adhishthanatvena kathyate. So what is this rajju? Rajju is the adhishthana for sarpa. Pratiyamana sarpasya rajvam pratiyamana sarpasya sarpa, which appears on the rajju. What is that? That is rajju adhishthanatvena kathyate. That itself is sarpa, is sarpasya rajju adhishthanatvena kathyate. It is finally nothing but sarpa. Sarpa is nothing but rajju itself appearing. So mandandakare pratibhasa mana sarpa brahmadhisthanasya prakasha sambandhe sati. When the same sarpa in the mandandakara, it is seen as sarpa, but that pratibhasa mana sarpa brahma, that brahma goes away when adhishthana is known. Adhishthanasya prakasha sambandhe sati. When the torch is shown upon the rajju, which is the adhishthana of the sarpa, meaning the rajju which was appearing as sarpa due to this manda andhakara, when you shine a light on the adhishthana rajju, then manda andhakara goes away. Due to light, the sarpa also goes away because rajju is seen as rajju. Rajju reva iyam iti nischaye jate. When this is rajju, this is a rope, when you have this ascertainment, nischaya tachana deva sarpo nivartate, that very moment sarpa goes away. Where does it go away? Tasma sarpa nivritti tadadishthana rajju sakshat karayoho cha ekakshanavachhedena jayamanatvat sarpa nivritti adishthana rajju matram bhavati. Sarpa nivritti is adishthana rajju matram, because in the same moment rajju, when you knew the rajju as rajju, the sarpa has gone away. Ekakshanavachhedena jayamanatvat, because sarpa nivritti and the rajju sakshatkara is in the same moment. In the same moment it has occurred, and thereby what you have seen is rajju. Sarpa nivritti is at the same moment because sarpa nivritti is rajju. That is, there is no difference between the two. Sarpa nivritti is what? Rajju eva iyam iti jnanam. That jnana itself is sarpa nivritti. Thereby rajju jnana being sarpa nivritti is rajju rupa, adhishthana rupa. So this is the detailed explanation of the tarka used above in a different language, different way to look at it. So that ends the tritiya, the prayojana of anubandha chatushtaya. Anubandha chatushtaya, the fourth one, last is sambandha. Vishaya, adhikari and prayojana have been dealt with. Now sambandha, the last one for anubandha chatushtaya to be completed, sambandha nirupanam. Granthasya vishayasya prameyasya cha pratipadya pratipadaka bhava sambandha. What is the connection between? There are four sambandhas between the grantha and the vishaya. What is the sambandha? With vishaya there has to be a sambandha, otherwise we won't study this grantha. Vishaya, what is the vishaya? We need to know what is the vishaya. Vishaya is prameya. Prameya vishaya, therefore pratipadya pratipadaka bhava sambandha. What is that vishaya? Vishaya is jiva brahma aikya. Jiva brahma aikya being the vishaya, which is prameya, to be known, we have to know prakarshena meya. We should know the aikya between jiva and brahma, meaning between myself and brahma, then only I'll get moksha. This is the vishaya of the grantha. So grantha and vishaya have a sambandha since the Vishaya Jiva Brahma Aikya is revealed in this Grantha, thereby Grantha and Vishaya have a sambandha. Grantha Pratipadya Pratipadaka Bhava Sambandha. What is the Pratipadya? Revealed. And Pratipadaka is the revealer. So revealer and revealed kind of an association is there. In that Grantha Pratipadaka, Grantha is the revealer, Vishaya Jiva Brahma Ikyam is the Pratipadya, meaning revealed. Yet, the definition is given, yet Vishayam Vivichya Bodhayati Tat Pratipadakam. Yat Bodhyate Tat Pratipadyam. So what is revealed is Pratipadya, and what is Vivichya, Vishayam Vivichya Bodhayati. What explains the Vishaya, what explains it and thereby reveals it, that is a revealer. So Grantha is a revealer since it explains the Vishaya subject matter in detail. Therefore, it is a Pratipadaka revealer, and the Vishaya is Pratipadyam because it is what is being explained here. Adhikari Phalayoho, second sambandha is between Adhikari, Adhikari and Phala. अधिकारी एंड प्रयोजन, प्रयोजन इज द फल. अधिकारी फलयोः प्राप्य प्रापक भाव रूप संबंध. संबंध इज बिटवीन अधिकारी एंड प्रयोजन. व्हाट इज द कनेक्शन? द कनेक्शन इज प्राप्य प्रापक भाव. प्राप्य प्रापक भाव रूप संबंध, प्राप्य एंड प्रापक संबंध. प्राप्य इज टू बी अटेन्ड, समथिंग टू बी अटेन्ड. प्रापक इज वन हु मेक्स. प्राप्य इज टू बी अटेन्ड, प्रापक इज वन हु अटेन्स. Attainer and attained connection is there. Phalam prapyam. Phalam is the moksha, is the attained. Adhikari is the attainer. Again, it is defined now. Yadvastu labhyate tat prapyam. Whatever is attained is called as prapya. Yo labdha sa prapaka. The labdru is prapaka. One who attains it, one who gets it is prapaka. That is the connection. अधिकारी विचारयोस्तु कर्तृकर्तव्य भाव रूप संबंध. बिटवीन अधिकारी एंड विचार, व्हाट इज द संबंध? कर्तृकर्तव्य भाव रूप संबंध. अधिकारी इज द कर्ता, विचार इज कर्तव्य. देयरफॉर दे हैव दिस काइंड ऑफ अ कनेक्शन. इट इज अ ड्यूटी. सो कर्तव्य इज ड्यूटी. बीइंग बोर्न एज अ ह्यूमन बीइंग, यू हैव टू बिकम एन अधिकारी. रियली एक्चुअली बीइंग बोर्न as a human being itself tells us that we are adhikari for moksha, because jnanena moksha, jnana can take place only in a chaitanya vastu which has a faculty which can do vichara. A human being can do vichara, other beings can also do vichara, but they cannot do vichara up to such an extent. They have only instinctual behavior, and vichara related to just the needs, to meet such needs. They don't have other baggage to take care of. You don't have a lot of vichara to do. Here, adhikari is a karta and vichara is kartavya. Adhikari karta, kartavya vichara. Yah karoti sa karta. One who does is a karta. Yat kriyate tat kartavya. What is done is kartavya. What is to be done is kartavya really. In our case, it is tavya. Tavya, tavya niya raha. It is something to be done. There is vidhi rupa really if you look at it. Grantha jnanayo janya janaka bhava sambandha. Between grantha and jnana, what is the sambandha? Janya janaka bhava. Jnana arises janya and Grantha causes it to arise, so it is janaka. Vicharadvara jnanam prati grantha janakaha. Vicharadvara, through vichara, grantha is going to give rise to knowledge, therefore it is janaka. Jnanam janyam, jnana is born, therefore it is janya. Yad utpadeti tad janakam, yad utpadyate tad janyam. What is born is janya, and what causes it to be born is janaka. Tat prayojaka hetuscha. Evam eva sambandhantaram api bodhyam. And similarly, other sambandhas also are to be understood. We look at in the tippanna. First sambandha is talked about here. Sambandha rupa anubandha kathane प्रयोजन वाय संबंध हैज टू बी इवन डिस्कस्ड वाय इज इट अ पार्ट ऑफ अनुबंध चतुष्टय यस्य वस्तुनो येन सह संबंधो भवति तस्य तद्विषये अपि उपयोग अस्ति वाय शुड वी नो द संबंध बिकॉज ओनली दैट विच इज कनेक्टेड टू इन द अनुबंध चतुष्टय इफ इट इज कनेक्टेड देन ओनली दे शुड बी डेल्ट इन टू दे शुड बी डेल्ट विथ अदरवाइज वी डोंट नीड टू डील विथ देम एट ऑल यथा एग्जाम्पल गिवन यथा कुलालादीनां घटादीना सह संबंधो अस्ति अतः कुलालादयो घटाद्युत्पत्ति विषये उपयुज्यन्ते वाई डू नीड अ पॉटर यू विल नीड अ पॉटर ओनली इफ द पॉटर इज कनेक्टेड टू द पॉट यू आर इंटरेस्टेड इन अ पॉट इफ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड इन द पॉट वाई डू यू लुक फॉर अ पॉटर बिकॉज ही इज कनेक्टेड टू द पॉट इन सम मैनर देर हैज टू बी अ संबंध Since Potter has Kulala, Potter has the connection with Ghata, which is what you want, the phala that you want. Thereby, you look for a Potter because of the sambandha. Ataha Kulala deo Ghata dyutpatti vishe upayujyante. They are to be used to get the pot. Upayujyante, use as in they are the means. Yasya yena sambandho nasti na tasya tad vishe upayogasti. What is not connected, you don't need it. Because you are interested in the phala, only those which are connected to the phala, you should be interested in. Others you can set aside. Yatha chakshusho vaivakashabhyam sambandha bhavat tadvishayi karane nopayogaha. Another example is given for to counter it. As to counter example as in sambandha, if it is not there, then you don't need it. It is not a means at all. Yatha chakshusho vaivakashabhyam sambandha bhavat sambandhasya abhavat. There is no connection of the eye with the Vayu or Akasha. Eyes do not cognize Vayu or Akasha. Therefore, Tadvishayi Karane is to objectify Vayu and Akasha. There is no use of eyes because eyes have no connection there. Evam Grantha Brahmano Sambandha Bhave Granthasya Na Brahma Vishayo Bhavet. Brahma, if you want, Brahma is not revealed by the Grantha. Brahma is Aikya is revealed. Brahma is not revealed. Brahma is your own Swarupa, of course, but your Swarupa is the connection between you and Brahma is revealed. Brahma is, if you know Brahma as Ishvara, as a creator, through other Shastras, then this Grantha is going to talk about what? It is going to talk about the Vishaya, which is Aikya between that Brahma and you. It has got a very focused approach. It is not going to talk about all sorts of things and then, you know, just leave the main points. It is focused on the main Prayojana, Vishaya, Ityadi. Thereby, Grantha Brahmano Sambandhave, Granthasena Brahma Vishayo Bhavet. If you want to know what is Brahma, this Grantha has no connection to that. Brahma is not explained. Aikya is explained. Main focus is Aikya. Of course, in passing, Brahma may be talked about, but that is not the Vishaya. Vishaya is where the main focus is. Subject matter, Tatparya, Vishaya is Tatparya Vishaya Kim. The Tatparya Vishaya Kaha, Granthasya, that is Aikyam. Aikyam is the Tatparya Vishaya. Grantho Apina Brahma Pratipadaka Syat. Therefore, Grantha is not the revealer of Brahma. Actually, Brahma is ever revealed. There is no revelation needed. Brahma is ever revealed. Not revealed as oneself, therefore we do not know that Brahma is revealed. We know that I am revealed, Brahma is not revealed. Brahma is, that's why Tat Padartha. Known through Tat Padartha, Tat is very far away because I do not know. Aikya. Tasmat paraspara upakara siddhyartha anayoho sambandha atadvyavrutya bodhya bodhaka bhava rupa kalpyate iti. Thereby, removing whatever is not connected, sambandha is talked about, which are connected. For what? Paraspara upakara siddhyartham. Connection is talked about so that we see usefulness of all of these participants in anubandha chatushtaya. Sambandhantara shabdena. So here sambandhantara also should be known in this manner. It is mentioned in the tippana as sambandhantara shabdena shravanadehe jnanena saha jnanasya cha mokshena saha sadhya sadhana bhava rupa sambandho vidnyeha. Connection between shravanadi, shravana mana nididhyasana, all these are connected with jnana. How? As साध्य साधन, श्रवण इज दि साधन, श्रवणादि साधन, ज्ञान इज दि साध्य. सो मीन्स एंड दि 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 द गोल इज वॉट साध्य साधन साधन संबंध ज्ञान से च मोक्षेन स ज्ञान ज्ञान मोक्ष देयरफॉर ज्ञान इज दि साधन मोक्ष इज साध्य. सो दिस इज हाउ वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड अदर संबंध ऑल्सो एज सेड इन दि मूल यस्ट संबंध. सो देयर इज अ श्लोक एंडिंग इन दि प्रथम तरंग यस्तु साधन संपन्नो जिज्ञासु प्रथमं पठेत इमं तरंगं सततं मुक्तो असौ नात्र संशयः. इति श्री वासुदेव ब्रह्मेन्द्र सरस्वती विरचिते विचार सागरे अनुबंध सामान्य रूप निरूपणं नाम प्रथम तरंगः. सो यस्तु साधन संपन्नः अधिकारी वन हु इज साधन संपन्न साधन चतुष्टय संपन्नः वन हु हैज द फोरफोल्ड क्वालिफिकेशन ऑफ विवेक वैराग्य समाधि षट्क एंड मुमुक्षुत्व जिज्ञासु एंड देयर बाय जिज्ञासु हु ही नोज दैट आई नीड ज्ञान ज्ञान इच्छु हु यह प्रथमं पटे प्रथमं प्रथम तरंग दिस प्रथम प्रथम प्रथमं तरंगं पटेत हु रीड्स दिस कॉल्ड एज अ वेव इन दिस ओशियन ऑफ विचार सागर हु स्टडीज दिस पटेत इमं तरंगं सततम मुक्ता असो नात्र संशयः. सो अर्थवाद इज डन व्हेन यू से पटे स्टडीज मीन्स वन हु अंडरस्टैंड दिस दिस इटसेल्फ मे इज सफिशिएंट बिकॉज ब्रह्म एंड जीव ऐक्य हैज बीन टॉक्ड अबाउट हियर एज वेल देयर बाय दिस वेव चैप्टर विच इज कॉल्ड एज अ वेव इन दिस ओशियन दिस बुक विच इज कॉल्ड एज ओशियन सततम प्रथमम इमं तरंगम सततम कंटिन्यूअसली ही रिमेन्स इन दिस then sah muktah asau muktah that person is definitely a mukta atra samshaya na kartavya samshaya nasti. This is the prathama taranga. We'll start with the second taranga dvitiya taranga in the next part. सुखम नित्यम सुप्रकाशम व्यापकं नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्यत्व निर्मलं अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक् परमः तदेवाहन्नमत्वन्य इति मे निश्चितामतिः. एनी क्वेश्चंस?
हरिः ओम् महोदय. सतीश राव संशय.
यू
आर टॉकिंग अबाउट अधिकारित्वम राइट समवेयर इन द अर्लियर पार्ट इट वाज रेफरेंस दैट समवन लाइक अ सन्यासी विल बी कंसीडर्ड एज उत्तम अधिकारी.
उत्तम अधिकारी बट सन्यासी इज द मुख्य अधिकारी हियर.
ओके सो दैट वाज माय मेन डाउट देन. सो इवन समवन हु इज इन से typical ashrama like a grihastha can become an uttam adhikari, is that correct?
See, through becoming an uttam adhikari is not an issue. The issue is sadhana, whether the person has had sadhana for uttam adhikari. See, for uttam adhikari upasana is prescribed. Upasana right. Should be continuous. Thereby why sannyasi is talked about is because there's a single focus. It is more conducive to an ashrama. Of
correct.
Course, today it is questionable because sannyasa ashrama itself, because of varnashrama dharma depleting, not having state support, it is depleting and thereby none of the ashramas are really the way the ashramas are meant in the shastra.
Sure.
So that is the difficulty. Otherwise, if we have to look at from the perspective of the shastra, the sannyasa ashrama is most conducive.
Sure, but it's not a necessity.
It is not a necessity. Orthodoxy will say later may be necessity, but it is a general rule. Exceptions are always there, but we have to look at them as exceptions only. One Janaka is talked about somewhere, someone else. It is difficult. Later stage, it is difficult because how is Nishtha possible? Nishtha is very difficult unless one has no responsibilities. Even the Nitya Naimittika Karma, if you look at from the Shastra perspective again, if a Grahastha does every Nitya Karma prescribed, he will have no time for anything else in the day except for a little rest. Nothing else is possible. Today we don't have nitya naimittika karma full-fledged. We don't have, we don't have, in a sense, people are unable to do Agnihotra. Agnihotra in Mundaka, we have seen in Agnihotra, there is a dependency of Darsha Purna Masa, ityadi, all of those are there.
Yep.
If a person, that's why, there is time of needed rest. Because you cannot keep on doing pathas continuously. There was a break given to patha also because there is exhausted karma. Upasana sahita. So it is not possible to do other karmas even in grihastha ashrama. Then you say, okay, you do shravana man nidhyasana. How is it possible to do shravana when nitya karma does not give you enough time beyond rest? So you have to look at from that perspective. So today it is possible, but uttama adhikarityam is bahu duram. Uttama adhikarityam, personally, I don't feel uttama adhikarityam is possible because we don't have even very rare examples even in Upanishads. So Uttamadhikari, the way Shastra talks about, such Uttamadhikaris are not there in Shastra also. Very rare. So otherwise, we see examples where people walk out from home. We don't have Uttamadhikari staying at home and it's not possible. There is a Sputa Virodha. When there is Jnanotpatti of such an extent, then one may or may not continue by Prarabdha. That's a different story.
Mm-hmm.
But Uttama Adhikarityam is questionable. Uttama Adhikari means just listening to Tattvamasi Vakya itself, there is Mukti.
Okay.
Adhikarityam, we have to try to become Uttama in whatever is best possible in our environment.
Sure. Thank you.
Anything else? Anyone else? Namaste. I'll see you in the next part. Did you have a question?
No. Thank you.